we hope to introduce you to some of the many interesting architectural and historical features of Ashford, once known as Eschedford, meaning the ford by the ash tree. You are standing in the Town Museum, built by Sir Norton Knatchbull as a grammar school for boys in 1635, and used as such until 1870. We will return here at the end of our tour. But now we will start at the parish church. Recorded in the Domesday Book, there are traces of Saxon, Norman, Early English and decorated styles, but the principal reconstructions and extensions date from 1475 by Sir John Fogg, whose tomb is seen here, and 1827. The vicarage was built in 1468 by Sir John Fogg as a college for chantry priests. The south wing was modernised around 1770. Note the Tudor doorway. Opposite, the northern half of the clergy house is timber framed, one room wide. The other half is a Victorian addition. Of these former cottages have been rebuilt during various periods as shops facing the High Street. Reversing the trends we have just seen, these later and Victorian modifications face the churchyard, while from the High Street they can be seen to be on one building, originally an inn, dating from about 1500. Some of the original timber construction is visible inside. Prominent in this view of the lower High Street is number 54, built about 1680, probably for a surgeon. The timber-framed building was extended along North Street, the top floor probably containing workrooms. This group of buildings is known collectively as Middle Row. The earliest, number one, dates from the 14th century. Beneath it was the town jail, known as the Cage. The 16th century extension extends eastwards and covered an open market area, and the entire building was probably a market hall. Painted plaster covers much of the external timber frame of this 16th century building, but the carved barge boards, the pendant at their peak with the Phoenix fire insurance sign below, and brackets remain exposed. The balcony with its Victorian railings was used by the town crier for proclamations until about 1920. Beneath it, this iron bar over the doorway and the hooks along the side wall were for hanging game carcasses. This whole area, used by the butchers, was known in many towns as the Shambles. The gable to number 10 bears similar features. The pendant is carved with the butcher's sign, a meat chopper, and the initials IHS, or John and Susan Horton, and the date 1659. A stone tablet with the inscription God Seat 1602 can now be seen in the Kentish Express offices. The building was a new market hall housing the courthouse on the upper floor and was largely rebuilt in the early 19th century. Believed to have once been owned by Sir John Fogg and willed to his widow in 1490, this is one of the oldest buildings in Ashford. Much altered and rebuilt since then, the rear elevation faces the churchyard. Although now one property, Clouds, the early 19th century part to the left was built onto a 17th century building less than 4 meters wide but over 16 meters long, which may once have been a weaving shed. Some of the original timbers are exposed on the upper floor. The First World War tank, believed to be one of only two outside a museum, was presented to the town in 1919. It once housed an electricity substation, an indignity atoned for by the provision of the canopy in 1987. The older Prince of Wales stands on the site of a mid-18th century cider works. Probably more of North Street remains substantially as built than most of Old Ashford, but as we have seen, modernisation has been an ongoing process throughout the centuries. The early Victorian façade hides another two-storey framed building. The cornice and high parapet wall with trompe-l'œil windows hid a low roof, now raised to make usable accommodation. Such constructions are known locally as folly houses. Constructed as a single large framed house, the left side had roof alterations to accommodate the taller 19th century windows. Mathematical tiles to the upper story are evidenced by timber battens at the corners. A medieval hall house with the cross passage, and probably a farmhouse, this building was modernised in the 19th century. Some of the original structure may be seen from Park Street at the rear, but this large window at the end of the cross passage is only visible from a private courtyard. Probably the best preserved and least altered medieval townhouse in Ashford, the doorway is identical in style to that of the vicarage. A stroll along Park Street, parallel to North Street, reveals a jigsaw puzzle of additions and roofs. At the north end, these clearly ecclesiastical windows, rescued perhaps by a conservationist of long ago when the church was being rebuilt, have been given a new home. Finally, when you return to the museum, look for the headmaster's and magistrate's chairs, the recesses in the walls, the names and initials carved in the panelling, and of course the many other exhibits illustrating just some of Ashford's history. Enjoy your tour.